All over the world, infections in the place where surgical incisions are made are a major cause of new illnesses, extended hospital stays, and even death. In the U.S. alone, these infections cost more than $3 billion annually. But in developing countries, those statistics are much worse. Stephanie Tsai reports on one scientist who's working on a more affordable way to detect these infections early. It's the latest in our series, Breakthroughs on the Leading Edge of Science.
The colorful one here is Prince.
And for the past year and a half, Deja Taylor has been developing a unique invention to detect infections after someone's had surgery.
I came up with color-changing stitches that provide early detection for infections with a specific focus on surgical site infections in developing countries because those can be very deadly if they're found too late.
How does it work?
When you have an infection, there's some chemical imbalances going on, and my stitches pick up those chemical imbalances, and then they change color because of what's going on, all the science stuff.
The stitches change color.
She can't get too specific because of a pending patent application, but Taylor says she uses sutures dyed with beet juice to make the magic happen.
Beets are natural indicators. So a natural indicator is just a baseline term for a substance that changes color when the pH changes.
Healthy skin is naturally acidic, but if a surgical site gets infected, that acidity decreases. When that change happens, Taylor's sutures go from a bright red to a grayish purple color. By the way, Taylor is only 17.
Deja T. Taylor.
And she just graduated high school in June. Her path to these color-changing sutures began junior year in a chemistry honors class.
This is the room. This is where it all started.
After a suggestion from Taylor's teacher, Carolyn Walling.
She sat in the front row the very first day, and when I brought up, would anyone like to do a science fair project, she raised her hand immediately, and she stayed after school, and she said, let's talk about this.
I read an article about how these scientists created these stitches that involved this really fancy technology that I perceived to be inequitable to those that would actually be able to need this technology.
In low and middle income countries, 8% to 30% of procedures result in surgical site infections. But so-called smart stitches require smart devices, which are expensive.
I said, hey, I can do it better, and I can do it more equitable.
Issues of equity are personal for Taylor. She and her mother, LaDonna, live in the suburbs of Iowa City, a predominantly white area, and they have experienced their share of discrimination. Taylor says her previous school even tried to keep her from joining a science competition team. The lack of representation was even more apparent at her first science fair.
She looked around and she said, I am the only black person in this room. And that was like one of those things where maybe you know it, but you don't really notice it.
You've never experienced the world that way, obviously.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And she looked at me and she said, well, I'm going to win this thing.
And she did.
Deja helped open her teacher's eyes to racial discrimination, and from creating Black History bulletin boards in her elementary school to co-chairing her school district's equity advisory committee, Deja's been on a mission to educate those around her. She sees her invention as another tool in that mission.
So what did it feel like when you saw that this worked?
Yeah, I was like, oh my gosh, I did science. Like,
she'd be in my room constantly. It was probably every Friday after school. She was in here cutting up beets and boiling beets. It was a good probably 4 to 5 months that she was working on it.
And it paid off.
And my project is a novel suture additive.
This year, she was named a finalist in the prestigious Regeneron Science Talent Search, a national science competition for pre-college students. Past finalists include Nobel Prize winners and MacArthur fellows.
From Iowa City, Iowa, please welcome 17-year-old Deja Taylor.
Taylor's work even landed her on the Ellen DeGeneres Show, where the host declared her the winner of the show's science fair, which, of course, is not really a thing.
That's a gorgeous trophy.
Yes, yes.
And all I had to do was come here.
Yeah.
Taylor's next big step, though, is college. In the fall, she heads to the University of Iowa.
I'll actually be majoring in political science, so really social sciences and getting in tune with that and creating this equitable plan on a greater scale.
And she's not done with her infection-detecting sutures yet. Taylor says she won't stop until the people who need the stitches have them.
What are you pinpointing as the challenge you're currently focused on?
So right now, it's just a pure focus of making this suture commercially viable so that everything can go smooth when everything goes to market and these stitches actually get to those developing countries.
There are still barriers to it being used in the real world, safe to say.
Yep.
But do you consider it a success either way?
Yeah, because it works. It does detect pH. It does change colors where it needs to change colors. There are just some details that need to be worked out, but they're not insurmountable.
While many in the medical community have praised the invention, there is a technical obstacle, sterilizing the sutures. But she has already overcome a major hurdle, helping others that look like her believe they can find success in science too.
Knowing that I've inspired people all over the world is the real prize to me. That's the real recognition that, hey, I'm doing good in the world and this isn't just for me. This project, this research is quite literally outside of myself.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Stephanie Tsai in Iowa City, Iowa.